Hello. This is a vlog, but this is also a short essay on grad school loneliness. Honestly, I should not even call this an essay. This is more of a mini rant and a documentation of my emotions at this stage of my career. I've just been thinking about grad school lately and how 2020, and to an extent this year, brought about doubts and challenges I had never in a million years thought I'd encountered. A lot of thoughts are flowing, but there has been no output because life has been taking over. So I forced myself to stop and think and learn. It's a weird belief, really, that getting a PhD is not only an academic challenge, but also a socially draining crusade to the frontier of knowledge. We are expected to conduct independent research, learn to think critically. You get the gist. What comes with this massive feat, though, is that even if we are a part of a bigger cohort of students, at least in my experience throughout these 3 years I've been in grad school, it eventually came down to myself as a lone snail chipping away at this big leaf that is my degree, the dissertation. It came down to ourselves, to me, to show up every day, power through when it seems impossible, make decisions, and deal with the consequences that come with them. We carry the weight, the anxiety, the success, the immeasurable imposter syndrome every single day until we cross the finish line, or at least we hope so. More likely than not, the feeling of not being enough, but not having anyone to truly commiserate with, will carry on for longer than just our PhD tenure. There is this analogy that I came across online. In a strange way, life in research-intensive academia is like a career in pro sports. There's intense work and competition involved in getting drafted and working your way through a rookie contract. Then, you land a lifetime contract. After that, how hard you work at your craft is up to you and your goals. Most people like what they're doing, want to stand out, and work hard. Some people coast, and some people do nothing but have luck on their sides time and time again. You're not exactly part of a team with collaborative efforts towards a big shared goal. You're an island, trying day and night to drift towards the continent of finally feeling worth it. Bleak, you may say, and bleak it is. I was drawn to academia and the prospect of doing a PhD for, sounds stupid, but idealistic reasons. When I first got into biomedical sciences, my goal in life was to become a physician scientist and patent lawyer. Weird, I know, but I believe that cost-prohibitive drugs represent a clear and present danger to our very existence. My ambitions were to create quality but affordable medicine that can better the health of patients around the world, regardless of age, gender, race, or religion, at cheaper prices than is presently offered. I also want to use skills as a patent lawyer to make sure that greedy corporations cannot hijack and gain control of my cheaper medicine and once again make it too expensive for people to afford. Well, circumstances have changed my plans dramatically, but I am fortunate enough to still be on a path of becoming a scientist, creating the next generations of pancreatic cancer therapies, and acquiring knowledge in the law world that helps me understand the legal, regulatory, and business implications of my science. I wished for the expertise in drug development and scientific thinking. What I wished for, I got. But I also felt preyed on for my idealism. The long-established world of academia had an order. And I came in, and I was fully imprinted to believe that I was there at the expense of my work-life balance, family, hobbies, to uphold the golden rule of publish or perish. Science becomes a chore, an utilitarian regime with benefits to humanity as a side product. There are many parts of a PhD that are intrinsically isolating. It's kind of inevitable, that we work alone a lot of the times, and that our non-PhD family and friends hardly understand what we go through, because this career, compared to the plethora of careers out there, can be too peculiar to grasp. As we progress, as we become experts in our own field, our own subfield of subfield, we will also inevitably be more and more isolated from our colleagues and even our own mentors. It's a struggle for me to not let that impending occurrence of this isolation take over my life. But I am lost, as in where to draw the line of how much is too much, how much time is too much time to devote to my lab work, and amongst the struggles to get that balance right, the world events of the past year piled on even more. Sometimes it feels like PhDs are the loneliest places in the world, a seed waiting to sprout but enduring the most unbearable darkness before that first moment under the sun. Wow, such rambling I had the past few minutes. If there's only one thing I hope my future self or anyone watching can take away from this, it's that the first step of reaching out from an island that we felt like we're on is as simple as asking for a free cup of water at Starbucks. You know, sharing my frustration with someone I see every day, how lonely I find my progress to be. Instead of trying to project an image of perfection and having our shit together, try accepting that the authentic versions of ourselves are probably never, never going to be perfect. We're always going to have that carefully curated images to present, and we're constantly under the impression that we gotta fake it till we make it. But what matters, at least to me, is that although it feels lonely, we are trying. Start small, be vulnerable, be kind to myself, and never be afraid as long as we're moving. Even 0.00001 centimeter is a distance forward.